Well, Jake Berry, I would argue that we're probably two of the lesser legends of Edinburgh, but nonetheless, we are in a new place here on the CW, but physically, spatially speaking, legends of Edinburgh. This place is phenomenal, man. People need to figure it out.
Yeah, it's a new, I guess you would say, luxury living for, especially for college students, right next to UTRGV, and they've got tons and tons of things to do with this place, a ping pong pool, you know, all kinds of candy right here. So, yeah, we're here and we're filming, and thanks to them for letting us do it here.
1815 West Chapin. Looks like a neat thing. Very artsy, very modern. Now, how modern will be District 316A this year? Everybody says Vela. What say you?
I think in this district, much like Memorial, Vela is the class act. But I will tell you that I think Edinburgh North has a good chance. They've got weapons. They've got defense. I think they can give Vela a run for their money. It'd be the first time Vela's been challenged in a long time.
Yeah, you know, Vela had that really tumultuous offseason. They brought in a new coach, John Campbell, who very intense and driven, very well respected. He was the coach of Brandeis when they beat North in 2009. They lose Christian Flores to Edinburgh North. That, to my, by my money, he's the best back in the Valley among them, Pedraza and a couple of others. But they pick up Mark Escavel as a transfer from North to Vela as a linebacker. So it's almost like a trade. The transfer window is open, and now we're ready for the season. Vela has a lot of talent, man. The thing they're working on right now is the offensive line. They lost three kids that went to college. They do have Jaden Borjas back, who was a preseason all-state pick by Texas Football Magazine. At this point in time, Vela looks to be the strongest team. Anybody that brings back Nate Garcia at quarterback is going to be strong, I'm telling you.
Yeah, and if you look, you know, this is that one year for them. I mean, we don't know what the offense is going to be because, you know, Coach Campbell likes to run the ball. He likes it almost like the old Edinburgh style where, you know, 3 yards in a cloud of dust. But usually up in San Antonio, he had guys that could go the distance.
He did. And this year, they're going to be challenged at running back because Mark Buehider transferred out to Freer. So there's a lot of movement in the Vela team. But anytime you bring back Nate and you bring back Nick Enriquez on defense, those are two of the top 10 players in the Valley.
Yeah, most definitely. But this district is a lot like the Memorial District in 36A, except for there's two teams vying for that top spot, and then everybody else kind of fills in those last two spots.
So what do you think about, let's stay with Edinburgh here for a minute. Edinburgh High picked third by Texas Football Magazine. Is that surprising?
It does, because, you know, not that what they did last year was smoke and mirrors, but they caught fire at the right time, right games. They really made some big plays.
Yeah.
And to expect that in year two, I don't know if that's going to be the case. I think it's like Wadis Lincoln a couple of years ago when they made the playoffs. You know, I think they're not going to sneak up on anybody this
no,
year.
No, they're not. They know they're a target. They lost a ton of seniors, 38, I believe. Here's the deal. That program right now has the belief. It's the same thing that happened with the Economides 4 or 5 years ago when Gabe Pena's system took root. They started to believe that they deserved to be there, and so they made their way in. We're going to see whether Edinburgh High does believe in itself. I've been to watch them, and they do. They're going crazy at practice, man. They're going to be faster. They're not going to be as big. And, of course, they're not going to have very much depth. But if things roll right for the Bobcats, I see them making it again. Them and North going to be a fun game. It's like you said, North has some ability, man. Christian Flores, there's 150 yards a game right there with four offensive line starters. The defense for the Cougars is working in some new guys, but you keep an eye on Mario, man. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Mario Rodriguez, that guy's going to be something.
Yeah, and if I'm looking at some of my dark horses to kind of make a statement in this district, it might be, you know, PSJA and Trey Guajardo coming back, PSJ Southwest, but they have a new staff there, you know, and that's going to be interesting.
Speaking of Southwest, new staff, they got the most veteran coaching staff in the Valley. If you think that having great veteran coaches gets you some wins, maybe that's why PSJ Southwest was picked fifth in Texas football ahead of PSJ North, who was seventh.
Yeah.
When I saw that, I was like, wow, man. PSJ North 7. But let's go back to Southwest for a second. They got some big kids. They got this big lineman, Diego Trevino. They got Becerra, the running back. Now, they should be, and people are talking about Southwest this summer. They got a little bit of size. They got some athleticism. Gosh, man, maybe they're going to be a surprise team, like you say.
I think so. You know, and this district is going to come down to the last two spots. It's going to be a rat race for that last two spots. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's going to be very tough.
You see the Bears finishing maybe the top two or three.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, with Guajardo, with Almaguer. David Chapa, that lineman.
They got a new coaching staff, Lupe Rodriguez, who knows how to throw the ball. I mean, he's coached some really good quarterbacks over at Mission Vets. I think that team is going to make leaps and bounds. People are going to have to watch out for them.
Well, I called it 2 years ago. I said, you watch the Bears. Maybe not next year, but the next. And so this is the year. And so the pressure's kind of on PSJA to come through. What about North? What about North? Seventh in the district? That's crazy.
And they were close last year.
Yes,
a lot of injuries down the stretch, and their defense really just couldn't hold them into games anymore. And, you know, then they, you know, they lose, you know, down the stretch all those games and get knocked out of the playoffs. But if you look at it, I think if you want to see, you know, have a coach that can get you through it, it's probably Kaufman.
I like their staff. They're a little young in certain places, but they've gotten bigger and stronger. I don't think PSJ North will finish seventh. I'm just going to say that right now. What about Memorial? 0-10 last year. They're going to be better. They're one of the three teams that brings back a quarterback. They've got some athletes, man. Escalante, Sal Ramirez. They've got some players. You know, I think that PSJ Memorial will definitely be better this year.
I think so, too. And I think teams are going to sleep on them, and they're going to shock somebody. Like, they're going to get one of those games early like Edinburgh did, where they shouldn't probably beat somebody, and they do.
And Economides, you know, 4 out of 5 years in the playoffs, but right now they've lost a lot of kids. They bring back some flyers. Pete Segura, they have the lefty quarterback, Albert Guerra. The problem on defense is that they only have a couple of guys, but boy, are they good. Nicholas Villanueva, the linebacker, and a guy that I think is a really excellent player, Rolando Alviso, 23. He's going to be a junior. He's a long, rangy, stocky hitter in the secondary. They're looking for a lot of guys that we ain't heard of yet to come on, but they see they have the belief. Memorial wants to build the belief. Edinburgh North has had a great team with a lot of talent. If they get the belief and if they finish down the stretch, they could easily challenge Baylor for the title.
I think so, too. And, you know, I liked the early season games because, you know, North is going to have some big games.
Always
right away.
A big schedule, tough schedule. That'll get you ready, man. Well, that looks like a pretty good district, but